Good morning, everyone. Today, we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 13, Photosynthesis in Higher Plants. And today, we will discuss about the different experiments that were done by the scientists in order to find out the process of photosynthesis. So, first of all, let us talk about the Priestley's experiment. In 1717, he did so many experiments so as to find out the process of photosynthesis. Clear? Now, firstly, what he did, he took a bell jar in that bell jar he placed a burning candle and a mouse. So here is a burning candle and there I am having a mouse. Clear? So he placed a burning candle and a mouse. Now after some time, what he observed? Think, what could be the observation? Yes, after some time, this candle, this burning candle, it got extinguished, right? And the mouse died. Now the question is, why? For this, he gave an explanation that this burning candle and this mouse during respiration and this burning candle during the process of combustion, both of them, they are using a component of air. Or I can say, he said basically, the burning candle and the mouse, they are basically damaging the air. Clear? And that's why, as a result, after some time, the component of air, it got properly damaged. And as a result, the candle got extinguished and the mouse got died. Clear? Now, in the second thing, what he did, along with the burning candle and the mouse, he took a mint plant. Okay, and then he placed the mint plant in the same setup. So now here is a mint plant, suppose. So here is a mint plant. Now, when he placed the mint plant in the apparatus, okay, he took a burning candle, a live mouse, and then a mint plant in the apparatus. And then what he observed, this candle, it keep on burning and this mouse, it was surviving now. Earlier, when the plant was not there, then the candle got extinguished, right? And the mouse got died. But now here, after placing the mint plant in the setup, the candle kept on burning and this mouse, it was surviving. Now, can you think why? Yes, the explanation was given by him that this mint plant is restoring that component of air which is being consumed or which is being damaged, rather what he said, the component of air which is being damaged by the burning candle and the mouse, that component of air, it is being replaced by this mint plant. So from here, he gave a hypothesis that the mint plant, or I can say plants, they used to restore a component of air that is useful for the process of burning and for the process of respiration. Am I clear? And in 1774, he discovered oxygen. This is an important point. Who discovered oxygen? Priestley in 1774. Clear? Now the second experiment was done by Jan Ingenhouse. Okay, so now let us study about the second point, that is Jan Ingenhouse experiment. Now what he did, basically he determined the role of light in the process of photosynthesis. Now here comes the question, how? He took the same setup that was taken by the priestley, means a Belzar. Okay. And in the Belzar, as you know, there was a burning candle. There was a mouse, a live mouse. And then there was a mint plant. So he took the same apparatus, clear? Now what he did? Firstly, he placed this apparatus in the sunlight. Now when the apparatus was placed in the sunlight, then he observed that this candle kept on burning and this mouse was alive. Why? Because now, due to this light, this plant is able to restore the amount of oxygen that is being used by these two. Now what he did next? He placed this setup in a dark room. Now there is no sunlight. As a result, there will be no photosynthesis, that we know now. But what he observed when he placed this setup in the dark room, he observed that this burning candle, it got extinguished. The mouse died. Now here comes the question, why? Although the mint plant is here, but still the candle got extinguished and the mouse got died. Why? Because here the plant is there, but the plant is not able to restore the oxygen which is being used by these two. And why is the plant not able to restore the oxygen? Because as sunlight is not there, light is not there, so this plant is not able to perform the process of photosynthesis. So basically, John Ingenhouse did experiment with the same apparatus to show that light is necessary for the process of photosynthesis. Now he did one more experiment in case of an aquatic plant. He took an aquatic weed. Weed are the unnecessary plants, clear? So what he did basically, suppose here I am having a beaker. Here I am having water. As he took aquatic plant. So here suppose I am having the aquatic plant. Clear? So here is aquatic plant. Now what he observed? When this setup was kept in the sunlight, again I am saying he determined the role of light for the process of photosynthesis. Clear? So when this apparatus was placed in the sunlight, then what he observed? He observed that the bubbles are there. Here. He was able to see the bubbles, and you know that bubbles are formed when there is evolution of a gas, and that gas was oxygen, which was described by Priestley earlier. He also said that the bubbles are there. He observed that the bubbles are there and the bubbles are of oxygen gas. Clear? Now again, the sunlight is necessary, as if the light is there, then this plant is able to produce the bubbles and the bubbles are of oxygen. Clear? Now what he did next? He just placed this apparatus in dark. Now think what will happen. Now the dark condition is there. If there is no light, then the plant will not be able to perform the process of photosynthesis. This I am telling now, they were not aware about photosynthesis. They were just observing. When the apparatus was kept in the dark, then he observed that bubbles were not there. Now if the bubbles are not there, then he concluded that oxygen is not being produced. It means the process that is responsible for the production of oxygen, it is not taking place when the light source is not there. So basically I can say that light is necessary for this process, and this process restores the amount of oxygen that is being used by the burning candle and by the mouse, by the respiration process by the animals. Clear? Now let us talk about the third experiment. Basically, this is not an experiment, this is just a hypothesis which was given by Von Sachs. Now the next is Sachs experiment, not basically experiment, it's hypothesis. What he said basically, he said in the plants, leaves are there, clear? And in the leaves, a special type of organelle is present. Today it is known as chloroplast. Okay, so he said that in plants, in the green leaves, there is present an organelle that is chloroplast, right? And this organelle, it contains a green colored pigment, and that green colored pigment, we know it is chlorophyll. So he said that in the plants, green leaves are present. These green leaves, they are having organelles, and these organelles, they are having a green colored pigment, that is chlorophyll. Clear? So basically we can just take it as for now. In the plants, as you know, green leaves are there, they are having chloroplast, and the chloroplast, they are having chlorophyll. Clear? So he said that in the plants, it was just a hypothesis which was given by him. There was no experiment done by him. So he said that in the plants, green leaves are there which are having an organelle that is having a green colored pigment. Now this green colored pigment is helping in the process which is able to restore the amount of oxygen. Clear? Or I can say this green colored pigment is helping in the process of photosynthesis. Okay. Now further he said that when the plant performs the process of photosynthesis, then at last it results in the formation of glucose that you know now. Right now? And at the last of the photosynthesis, glucose is being produced, and then this glucose is stored in the form of starch. Am I clear? So this was a hypothesis, a generalization which was given by the Sack. He said that plants, they are having green leaves. The green leaves, they are having an organelle that is having a green colored pigment, and this green colored pigment helps in the process of photosynthesis, due to which there is production of glucose, and this glucose is stored in the form of starch. Am I clear? One more thing. As I told you, plants are having green leaves, but there are in a certain cases, there are some other plants, there are a few parts that are also green and can perform the process of photosynthesis. Like its best example is stem in case of cactus. You might be knowing stem in case of cactus is green in color. Why? Because it is having chloroplast. In that case, the stem of cactus, it is performing the function of photosynthesis. Clear?